kaunina muistona Karjala maa, mutta vielä...
Good morning, crew. My name's Hector from Out the Gate. I've had a fucking shit night's sleep because Exeter slept on the couch last night. He was howling like some sort of fucking demon through the night. I think that's enough. All I know is that every time he stays over, the fucking couches start growing dreadlocks in the morning and they've been up snipping those off and...
B, you know what it's like when they call for you in the nighttime?
Who was calling?
B.
Now, remember from yesterday's episode, I got bailed up doing a skit at TVNZ. The producer, Jim, he didn't like the fact that I slipped the child support bit back into the skit about the guided meditation.
B, do you want to come over to my pad?
Nah, B, fuck your house. Your uncle's always trying to flirt with me.
Hey, Hector. Mean ass, B. Or you could come sit on my lap.
Nah, B.
No, I think he's on holiday out in Paremarema.
How about we get out of these fucking shit clothes, go out to the man cave, and we'll throw the TV on.
Fuck, you got a mean pad
Let's
out
just
here.
Have a flick through, eh?
It's the banks. It's the fucking corporations, bruv. Have you not been fucking listening? It's the voices, bruv. Bruv, are you still watching, bruv? I think I've put more into our relationship than you have, and I'm about to engage in an act of hooliganism, bruv.
Figure out what it is you're good at, become the best at it, and success will follow. I film kids, and success has come with
it.
Fuck.
Zach's in the military. I raised my son to be a boy.
My fellow Americans, you're gonna have to bear with my Joe Biden accent because it's fucking terrible. Not that. Remember? Who did Princess Diana give my sunglasses to? The dead Sherpas, they were guiding us there. The Half Dream, the place we used to live there. And the Voodoo Swamp Priests, they came. They explained how to find the craft, I know they explained it, because we took a team there. Remember, it crashed into the Congo. We took the being out of the craft. We actually cared for it. We have it still, it's in Nevada. It's underground. Don't you remember? Some of the staff, they complained of our cruelty. I remember seeing it. We used its own technology. We created a device to drink from it. We were milking it. It was changing us. Do you remember what the fluid did to us? It was not alive, but it was ridden from the burrow. It was in stasis. Do you remember? Remember the iron we brought to Europe? Do you remember that? Do you remember the Omega point? Do you remember the all potential? It reaches a singular point in the nothingness. Do you remember where I put my fucking sunglasses?
Fucking
God damn.
And the inventor of the PCR test, which is a load of bullshit. Do people not realise how Hitler got into power?
What are you fellas watching?
Have people forgotten what happened in Nazi Germany?
Oh, I'm glad you're here, because I've been checking the fucking account and your rent hasn't come in yet.
I know.
That little weasel in the media, Chris Hipkins and his little mate, Four Eyes. I hope they all get locked up one day. That's just disgusting.
What's me to go to jail? How many layers of irony is this cunt on?
Go out there, exercise fresh air, get in nature, eat well, eat nutritious food, look after your body. It's as simple as that. You look after yourself, your body will look after you. Turn your TVs off. It's just propaganda. It's bullshit. Absolute bullshit. It's not about health. Never has been.
Hey, throw on that Dr. Pete Evans PhD.
Wait, you mean that fucking celebrity chef from Byron Bay?
He's a doctor.
A doctor.
Wake up, sheeple!
So I had a patient come to me hospital the other day and he says,
I've just seen my oncologist, and he's told me that I've got a neuroendocrine tumor, and it's malignant, and it's metastasizes. It's gone to my brain. And I said, well, what did he recommend you to do? Well, he recommends chemotherapy, radiation therapy, and surgery. And I said to him, mate, I have a better idea. Maybe we should look at meditation. We should look at what a wonderful diet can do for you. And most importantly, for 15 grand, I can teach you what self-love means to you. His wife rings me up a month later and she says,
me husband's bloody died, you inbred fucking f***er.
And I said to her, hey, look, everybody has their own truth, and I choose not to believe that narrative.
Hey, mate, how is she?
Mate, she's doing okay, but her leg's pretty badly broken. I mean, to be frank, it's pretty fucked from the right hip down.
Okay, you bring her in, and I'll grab her handbag and her purse.
This poor bloody woman here behind me, she's been in a car crash, right? And if that isn't enough, the fucking rescue helicopter paramedic says she has a broken leg. He calls her broken. I just reject that. I just reject the idea that people can be broken like a fucking plate or a glass cup. And then he says, we've plugged up a couple of holes, her hip needs an x-ray. X-ray? Do you know that x-rays have radiation in them? Anyway, I've absolutely wasted the last 45 minutes rummaging around everywhere for her EFPOS card so I can pay wave the bloody avocado infusion. And I can't find the thing for the fucking life of me. This is what I have to deal with.
The TVs. It's fucked these days. But anyway, sunset time.
But are these Bloomfield's tunes?
Oh, the fuck.
Has he got a job yet?
Yeah, I think he started up at Binin.
Binin? When are you gonna tell me what happened before my amnesia?
But you're trying to get your fucking character arc cranking so early, mate. This is the second episode. You turn up to the first one with a fucking sunken and fucked up face. They put you on Instagram, I seen it, and it said steal his look, and you swipe and it's a fucking pothole. And then in this episode, at the start, you're going on about the fucking, the things coming to you in the night or some shit.
I'm having flashbacks, B.
Okay, you want to do this? I'll bust out the calamus then, B.
I'm keen.
Holy fuck.
Yeah, it's me.
Babe, do you think you've offended people in this episode?
How can you not offend people these days, babe? Okay, babe, let's test your memory. Do you remember living in the French forest of Gévaudan in the 18th century?
Gévaudan?
Bro, your past self would be fucking embarrassed. Look, I'm sorry, though. Just stay vacant. The time will be right soon.